Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new here, my name is Lamia, and today I'm going to be giving you guys a recreated look of one of Carly Bybel's New York Fashion Week looks. I've been wanting to do a look inspired by Carly Bybel for a really long time because she's honestly one of my biggest inspirations on YouTube, so I'm super excited to be filming this video for you guys today. The outfit that I'm wearing is also super inexpensive, so if you guys want to see where I got this look from, then just stay tuned to the end of this video. Before we get into this video, if you guys like me and you like my channel, please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe. I would love to have you guys here. So without further ado, if you guys want to see how to get this look, then please keep watching. I'm honestly so excited to be filming this video right now because I've been wanting to do a Carly Bybel inspired look for so long, especially when I saw that picture because I just love that look so much. Please excuse my chin. I just started taking biotin again for my hair and it never really freaked me out before, but I can't really think of anything else because I never typically break out like this. The first thing I'm going to be using today is the Maybelline Master Prime Blur and Redness Control Primer. I like the way that this primer leaves me with a super smooth base, so that's why I'm going to be using it today. I also did my eyebrows before this video because it was super difficult for me to try to get my eyebrows to look like hers. They honestly still don't look like hers because our eyebrows are honestly a completely different shape and she has thinner eyebrows than I do. So I even had to conceal like on top of my eyebrow hair in some places. So it kind of looks crazy, but I knew that I just wouldn't be able to do it on camera because it honestly took me an hour just to get them to look somewhat similar. So I'm actually gonna take a pretty big risk today because I've never tried this foundation. I actually bought it a pretty long time ago. I bought it like almost a month ago or 3 weeks ago or something, and I still haven't tried out this foundation. It's the Hourglass Vanish Stick foundation. I mainly want to use it because I know she always likes her full coverage foundations, and I hear that this one is pretty full coverage. It's the only full coverage foundation that I have, so I thought I would just use it today. So I'll give you guys my first impressions along the way, but I'm just going to put this all over my face and blend it in with a black beauty blender. I know that it's advised to use a brush with this, so I actually might try and buff it out with my Sigma F80 brush first, and then if I don't like that, then I'll just use my beauty blender. Well, that's definitely way too light for me, but I'm going to be cream contouring and stuff. Oh my god, I cannot believe how light this is. The lady at Sephora tried to shade match me. I feel like I'm always just better off shade matching myself because every time I get shade matched, it's like not my shade whatsoever, and when I pick it myself, it's fine. Anyway, we're just gonna move on. I'm definitely going to exchange it, but we're just gonna leave it for now. But overall, I really do like the foundation. It's super full coverage. There's a little hair. But I'm just gonna go in with my Tarte Shape Tape in the shade Light Medium Honey, and I'm just going to put this underneath my eyes, and it's basically the same shade as the foundation. That's cool. And then I'm gonna go into the Graftopian palette, and I'm going to take one of these darker shades down here and use it to contour my face. And I'm gonna use my Morphe M210 to apply it. I know they say you can't go home again. And then I'm gonna contour my nose the same way that Carly Bybel does. I know you don't know me from Adam. But these hands, I'm just gonna bring the Tarte Shape Tape a little bit closer to the sides and in the center. I'm just going to blend everything with my beauty blender. And I'm gonna blend the cream contour with my Morphe M436. And then I'm gonna take this brush right here and just push the concealer over the nose contour. I also forgot to add some down to my jawline, so I'm gonna do that as well. All right, so I think that's about as good as it's gonna get. Next, I'm gonna go in with my Dermablend Translucent Powder, and I'm just gonna bake under my eyes and some underneath my contour, my chin, and my forehead. After I've set my face, I'm going to go in with my Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer, and I'm just going to take this onto my Morphe M523, and I'm going to bronze up and contour right over where we use the cream contour. I'm also going to take this Wet n Wild bronzer because I feel like my face is still so much lighter than my neck. And I'm just going to bronze my face with this in hopes that I can fix this. All right, I think that's a little bit better. I'm gonna move on to my eyes now, so I'm just gonna zoom you guys in a little bit more. So to prep my eyes, I'm gonna be using my YSL Couture Eye Primer in the shade Fair. And for eyeshadow, I'm of course gonna be using my Karli Bybel palette, but since I only have the first one and not the second one, there's no orange shades in this palette. So I'm gonna have to use my Kylie palette just for the orange transition shades. So I'm gonna go with this orange shade right here onto my Morphe E23 brush, and I'm just going to put this all into my crease. I'm actually also gonna go into my Master by Mario palette, and I'm going to take Isabelle onto my Morphe M441 and lay that right on top. So now I'm gonna go into my Karli Bybel palette. I'm just gonna take this shade first onto that same brush, and I'm going to put that a little bit lower into my crease. Then I'm gonna go in with my Morphe M433, and I'm gonna take the more purpley shade and also put this into my crease. Then I'm just going to take some of my Tarte Shape Tape onto a flat brush, and I'm just going to half cut the crease. Then I'm just going to go back in with that purple shade and bring it a little bit closer onto my lid. Then I'm going to take this deep purple shade and put this on my complete outer V. So I think she has a goldish shade in her inner corner and kind of on her lid. So I'm going to take these two combined, and I'm going to put them on my inner corner, but also kind of bring them into the inside of my lid where we have like those blank spaces. I'm just gonna go in with my Maybelline Curvitude Liner, and I'm gonna make two wings on my eyes. I'm next just gonna go in with my eyelash curler, and then I'm going to apply my L'Oreal Voluminous Million Lashes Excess Mascara. For lashes today, I'm gonna be applying my Huda Beauty Samantha lashes. Alrighty, so I look a little bit different now because I not only added lashes, I also added some contacts. These are just the Solatica lenses, and I believe they are in the shade Quartzo. So I'm just gonna move on to my lower lash line. I'm just gonna take the shade Isabelle, and then I'm also going to take a black shade, the black shade called Obsidian, from the Kylie Bronze palette, and I'm going to put both of those shades underneath my lower lash line. I'm just going to add some mascara to my bottom lashes. I'm gonna go back into the Carly palette and I'm gonna highlight my nose, mixing this shade and this shade up here together. And I'm also going to put some of it into my inner corner. I'm gonna take this Napoleon cream blush. This is in the shade Nikki's Rose, I believe. And I'm just going to take some of this onto my finger and pat it onto my cheeks. I'm also just going to take a very small bit of this blush right here because Carly doesn't like that much blush on her cheeks, but I'm still gonna add a little bit just to the high points of my cheekbones. And I'm just gonna line my lips with this Maybelline Color Sensational Lip Liner in the shade Nude Whisper. And I'm also gonna overline my lips because she has much bigger lips than I do. Then I'm just going to take my KKW by Kylie Cosmetics lipstick, and this is in the shade Kimberly. And I'm just going to put this onto my finger, and I'm going to dab it onto my lips. So I'm just gonna set this into place with my Maybelline Master Fix Setting Spray. So for my hair, I just straightened it the way that I typically straighten my hair. If you guys wanna see how I straighten my hair, then I have a tutorial up on my channel of how I usually straighten it. I just did it the exact same way, except I put it into a middle part. So my hair is honestly supposed to be black, but for some reason it likes to fade at the top. So I went ahead and bought EverPro Gray Away Temporary Root Concealer, black/dark brown, and I'm gonna be really extra and spray the top of my hair with this. That way it matches and it's super dark like Carly's hair. I'm also just gonna go ahead and put this choker on. Hers actually had like studs on it, but the only thing that I bought out of the outfit was the jacket, which I'll show you guys in a second, but I'm just gonna go ahead and put this choker on. So for the outfit, this choker was actually gifted to me. Thank you, Jonquil, if you're watching this. And then this blazer, I actually just bought today, last minute. I was just gonna wear a pea coat I had, but I went into Target to buy this spray right here, and when I was there I was like, I might as well go see if they have a blazer, and they had this one, and it was only $30, and it looks almost identical to the one that she was wearing. So this is definitely a cheaper alternative. And then the top she had is a little bit different, but I already had this top in my wardrobe. It actually had peplum on the bottom, and I just cut it off. And then I tucked in some of it, and the top is actually like more of like a sweetheart neckline, but I tucked in the top as well to make it straight across. And this was from Forever 21, but hers was actually also from Forever 21, so they're both pretty inexpensive. So this is the final result. I know that I look absolutely nothing like her, but this is my attempt at her New York Fashion Week look. And I honestly love the way it turned out. This is definitely going to be an outfit that I'm going to be wearing for an event that I need to dress up for. I just think that it's such a cute and fun way to be dressed up and professional at the same time. So if you guys like when I recreate other people's looks, then definitely give this video a thumbs up and let me know down below, because I love doing these and I would love to do more for you guys. Thank you so much for watching this video again, and until next time, I'll see you guys later.